Hello everyone, so we are going to start the Smith chart part 2, in which we are going to study how to find the input impedance. If you have a given load and then line for a particular frequency, then how to calculate the input impedance using Smith chart. So first of all, what you need to understand in a Smith chart for calculating input impedance is so you know about this. This is the real axis of reflection coefficient. This is imaginary axis of reflection coefficient. And this line is outer boundary of Smith chart. Outer boundary means this circuit is representing R equal to 0. And you also know this is short circuited and this is open circuited. I am not representing the resistance circuit and reactance circuit to make it more clear. Now next will be the wavelength towards load and wavelength towards generator. How will you find wavelength towards load and generator? After this outer boundary, there are several boundaries, several scales, in which in one of the scale you can find angle of reflection coefficient, you can find angle of transmission coefficient, then wavelength towards load, then you have wavelength towards generator. So these are nothing but scales which is incorporated with the Smith chart. So we'll be seeing this scales. The first scale represents the angle of reflection coefficient and this or transmission coefficient. It varies upon different Smith chart. So you can look into your Smith chart and they will mention in which street is angle of reflection coefficient, angle of transmission coefficient and wavelength towards load or wavelength towards generator. I am going to basically discuss the value of this wavelength towards generator and load. So when you are moving from load to generator, so this is your load side and this is your generator side. So if you are moving from load to generator side on transmission line, you have to move clockwise on Smith chart. I repeat, if you are moving from load to generator, you have to move clockwise on Smith chart. Similarly, if you are moving from generator to load, you have to move anti-clockwise on Smith chart. So for these two different movement, they have already given the scale on the Smith chart. If you are moving towards generator, means you are moving towards generator clockwise direction, the starting point will be 0 lambda. And one complete circle represents lambda by 2. That means if you complete the circle, it will become lambda by 2. So this lambda by 2 means 0.5 lambda is divided in equal parts over this perimeter. So this is 0 lambda, which will also represent 0.5 lambda if you complete a circle. If you complete one more circle, then this will become 1 lambda. So right now we are going to concentrate on one circle movement. What will be the value of different scales? This is 0 lambda, obviously this will be 0.25 lambda. 0 lambda, complete circle is lambda by 2, so half circle will be lambda by 4, that is 0.25 lambda. Then half of that will be 0.125 lambda. So similarly you can write different value of lambda and scales. This is how they have represented on this measure, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4 and so on. Here 0.1 to 5 means next will be 0.13, 0.14 and so on, then 0.24, 0.25 lambda, 0.26, so on. This will become 0.375 lambda. This 0.375 lambda means just next to that you have 0.38 lambda and it will reach to 0.5. 0.5 lambda is this point. Okay. It is just equivalent to taking angle from 0 to 360 degree. So if you take 0 to 360 degree, 0 and 360 degree will be on same point. 180 degree will be in opposite side, which is half of 360 degree. Same way, this is 0.5 lambda and 0 lambda will be on same point. Half of that is 0.25 lambda, which is opposite to that. And this is 0.125 lambda. And the lines are intersected equally. This is divided equally so that you can find on which position currently you are there. Okay. So when we will move from load to generator or generator to load, if the load information is given and generator information need to be found, we will move from load to generator. If the generator information is given and we need to find the load, then we will move from generator to load. And what will be the scale for that? So this scale is nothing but towards generator. Towards generator. This scale 0 to 0.5 in clockwise direction is towards generator. If you move towards load, means opposite direction, just make this scale in opposite direction. How will you make that? 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6 and so on, 0.125. This is 0.25. So in both the cases, 0.25 will be same because this is half of the scale. So either you are moving from load to generator or generator to load, you have to reach at the half point, which will have the same value. Then 0.25, 0.26 and so on, you will get 0.375 here for the load. So I just mention that another thing. So in this circle we are going to mention the scale towards load. Is 0.125 lambda, 0.25 lambda, next will be 0.26 lambda, this one will become 0.375 lambda, finally here we have 0.49 lambda and 0. If you superimpose these two scales on different line, what you will notice is the addition of two values will be always 0.5. If I say this is 0 lambda and in the towards generator circuit this was 0.1 and now this is 0.49, so addition of 0.1 and 0.49 is always 0.5. Similarly, it was 0.125 for load towards for movement towards generator. And for movement towards load, we have 0.375. If you add these two, it is 0.5. So both scales are related to each other. It represents separately to make your work easy. But if you know one scale, you can find another scale just by calculating it using this formula. That means, suppose the scale of towards generator and the scale towards load, both you are adding, you will get 0.5 lambda always. So if you don't know the scale of generator, then what you have to do? Just find the scale of load and take the difference, you can find it. So that is about the representation of load and generator movement. Now we are going to solve problems. in the first problem, I'm going to take a load value, which is 60 plus 80 J ohm. This is the load value. We have a characteristic impedance of 50 ohm. We are also choosing a frequency, say 3 GHz, and length. So at this frequency, what will be the lambda? Lambda will be 3 into 10 to the power 8 C by F, 3 into 10 to the power 9. How much you are getting? This is C by F, lambda is C by F. So to cancel it, you will get 0.1 meter, that means 10 centimeter. So your lambda value is 10 centimeter. So let us say length is 4 centimeter, 3 centimeter length. Let us say length is 3 centimeter and we have to find the input impedance. So what will be the procedure? Reflection coefficient, VSWR, return loss. These are already found in the previous lecture. Now we are going to find the input impedance. So first of all, you have to normalize this. That is equal to 1.2 plus 1.6 J. If you normalize it 50 ohm, 60 by 50, 1.2, 80 by 50, 1.6. And 1.2 circuit will be somewhere here, because R equal to 1 circuit will pass through the center, so R equal to 1.2 will pass just after the center. Similarly, 1.6 circuit will be something like this, because 1 circuit will pass through this, and more than that value, the circuit will be small in radius. So the intersection point is your load. What you have to do? You connect this center through the point and extend it to outside the switch. Then in the last strip on the Smith chart, you have representation of wavelength towards generator. So in the last strip, you have wavelength towards generator, and what is the expected value? Can you just tell me the range? Yes, the range is 0.125 lambda to 0.25 lambda. In between, you have some value. You can read that value using a Smith chart and find the current position of load. So let us say, for example, since I am not going to solve directly on a Smith chart, so I don't know the exact value of this. So let us say this value is 0.16 lambda. So the current position of load is equal to 0.16 lambda, and we have to find input impedance. But length is given in centimeter, so we have to convert this length in terms of lambda. How will you convert that? Since you know the length of wavelength of this frequency, so what you can do is L equal to 3 centimeter only we will write, 3 centimeter. We will divide it by 10 centimeter and multiply by 10 centimeter. So, problem. So, if you take this ratio, it is 0.3 and 10 centimeter is your lambda. So, L is what? L is 0.3 lambda. Means you have to move 0.3 lambda from the current position towards the generator. So, your current position is 0.16. How much you have to move? Current position is 0.16. You have to move by 0.30 lambda. To add these two, we have 0.46 lambda. So this is your final position. load, load is at 0.16 lambda. You have to move by 0.30 lambda. So the final position will be 0.46 lambda. To find that, you can move on this circle, this strip, in the wavelength towards generator strip, and then you will find that 0.46 will be somewhere here. Why it is somewhere here? Because it is 0.5, then 0.49, 0.48, 0.47, and this will be 0.46. Connect this point to the center of the smith chart. So our input impedance should be on this line, but there will be only one point on this line. We have to find out that particular point. What we have to do? You have to draw a constant VSWR circle. Constant VSWR circle means if you are moving along a transmission line, the VSWR is always constant. Whether you move from generator to load or load to generator, if there is a single section of transmission line, VSWR will remain constant. If there is some discontinuity, then only VSWR will change. So if there is no discontinuity from the load to generator, we don't have discontinuity right now. So we will be drawing the constant VSWR circle, and constant VSWR circle means we have to take this earth, we have to take this earth and draw a circle. This circle. So that the VSWR value, whatever is here, will be there. This is the VSWR value. So for all the loads on this circuit, VSWR will be same. But our load exists at this length. So the intersection of these two will be your input impedance, normalized input impedance. So normalized input impedance, how will you calculate it? You have to read the resistive part by moving on constant resistance circuit. Here, what is the value? I don't know the exact value. Let us say if it is 0.4, then you have to read that 0.4 from here, and then reactive value will be this circle. This circle. You can find the reactive value. That will be also in the range of 0.4 or 0.5, maybe less than that, but it will be between 0 to 1. So you have to exactly find on a smith chart what is this value. Okay, and then multiply with 50 ohm. Multiply with 50 ohm to get the input impedance. Now the question is whether this load will be capacitive or inductive. As this is in the bottom half, it will be, the load will be capacitive in nature. So suppose you have found this value, we can write this input impedance here. The input impedance will be 0.4. I am just assuming the value 0.4 minus 0.3j. So need to multiply with 50 ohm to get the actual value of input impedance. So if you multiply this with 50 ohm, 20 minus 15j ohm. So this is your input impedance. Now if somebody asks you what will be the reflection coefficient at this point, because we have already found the reflection coefficient at this point in previous lecture, the method will be same. You have to measure this OA, then OB to find the reflection coefficient here as well as here. So your reflection coefficient value, you can notice that OA and OB is not going to change because this is a circle, and radius is not going to change. So then you don't have to calculate magnitude again. If you have already calculated the magnitude here, magnitude will be same here. What you have to do is, you just need to calculate the angle of reflection. Because angle will change at each and every point on constant VSWR circuit. So if the angle is here is 45 degree or 60 degree, this angle will be below this, how much it is? 180 degree. this is 190 or 195 degree. So you can go in negative direction and say it is around 165. So I am just assuming the angle as 165 degree, refraction coefficient magnitude, and then whatever angle you are getting, that will be the refraction coefficient. So for the given load, please calculate the value and write in the comment box. The answer, input impedance and reflection coefficient, VSWR, etc., write in the comment box so that we can verify whether we have understood this correctly. Thank you very much.